It's a distressing thought, but internet porn may be replacing sex ed for kids in the digital age. A shocking percentage of pre-adolescent children are being exposed to cyber porn long before they're mature enough to process its graphic sexuality. It fills parents of preteens like me with dread. And add to that those explicit lyrics in hip-hop and the elixir of social media, and suddenly, the facts of life are X-rated.
9 out of 10 children between the ages of 8 and 16 have viewed pornography on the internet. Winifred's friend Danielle was 11 the first time she stumbled on it.
A very wise man once said, "Evil can only prevail when good men do nothing." Just as wildfires can destroy a whole forest if left unattended. You see, Anonymous believes all children born on Earth are entitled to have a future. A future where their childhood is still granted its innocence. A future where love and affection still exists, instead of lust and addiction. When people in the future review what our pop culture was doing at the turn of the 21st century, they will see this. This is not comical, this is embarrassing. You can't pretend that this is normal for children to mimic. They only have to turn on their televisions to see for themselves that America is starting to lose its moral compass. Our culture is ripping at the seams and nobody seems to care. In fact, they will see that adults are actually encouraging it, and grow up thinking that this is normal expected human behavior. It is becoming clear that our media is beginning to erode society's sense of shame and dishonor. But Anonymous does not encourage it, and we won't stand silent where words need to be said. So please bear with my opening statement before our show begins. In all honesty, we didn't take blind shots at Mr. West for no reason at all. It simply had to be said and done. You just don't build a career attracting a fan base for Christians to follow you, and later lead them to perversion, then capitalize off the negative publicity from that, without hearing from us. Our critics need to recognize immorality when they see it, especially when pertaining to any celebrity that young teens look up to and adore. We are shunning bad celebrities so kids can witness that not everyone approves of corruption and there is punishments for those that have fallen down the wrong path. Of course Anonymous has bigger fish to fry, but we can't allow new problems to grow either. Children are the roots to the future. And if they get corrupted before they have a chance to change, then we are back to square one again battling another wave of corrupted adults. We all are obligated to stop corruption right at its roots before it grows too big to handle. The support we got has shown that many adults agree that something needs to change. So many might wonder, of all the other trash-filled celebrities, why did we pick on Kanye West? In case you have forgotten, Mr. West started off this year using a very distasteful tactic to gain your attention and completely ruined a unique historical moment in human history, overshadowing it with Kim's photograph with Paper Magazine. How can you claim to be a Renaissance man, and then promote nudity at a time when revolutionary things were happening with NASA? And yet, he thinks all his ideas are so profound. He thinks being a pop star automatically makes him the next Michelangelo, or Jesus, without even possessing the mind that goes with being a great teacher. This is less than laughable, Anonymous has simply had enough of the majority's tolerance and negligence to stop things like these. So, we did something about it and made an example of him. And this goes not just for Kanye West, but also Lil Wayne, Nicki Minaj, Katy Perry, Rihanna, Lady Gaga, Kesha, and Miley Cyrus. And speaking of her, Miley, what happened to you? You had it all, and now you blew it. You had so much potential to be the next Celine Dion of your generation. You could have been the greatest icon for women to be proud of and admire throughout history. You could have been a positive inspiration to your young fans. You could have been the one woman to change the industry to finally stop using female vocalists as sex objects. But instead, you decided to conform with the rest of them. Now people will only remember you for your downfall. Don't you want to be remembered for your bright personality? Your soul? Or even, your ideas? We are not attacking you, young lady, we only wish to send you a heart, so you know that someone cares. We want you to understand that each time you push limits to be more controversial, you are only destroying the lives of countless children who are watching. You came in like a wrecking ball indeed, more like an atomic bomb, but your life had always been in the hands of Disney's perversion, so this is no surprise to us. But it is surprising that you don't even resist your own enslavement. You are no longer a person with feelings, your life now belongs to the sex industry. And you won't ever be happy, once you realize that nobody loves a whore. I wonder, how does it feel to be just an emotionless body for perverted eyes to lust over? Don't you feel robbed of your personality? Don't you have something valuable you've always wanted to share with the world instead? Well, nobody will ever take you seriously now. And you push these careless values on all of your old fans, who are still under the age of 18 and confused about where they should be in life. Shame on you, Miley, for being so stupid to fall for this. You are the epitome of everything that is wrong right now with America. Which brings up my final point. Artists like Miley wouldn't even exist in the spotlight in the first place if it weren't for the fans who continue to fund their careers when they take a turn for the worst. You see, this message is not for Mr. West or Miley Cyrus. This message was to you, the viewer. Because it is you, the consumer, who might have bought these artists' products and made them as successful as they are. Every one of you who claim to be fans of these trash celebrities had been voting with your dollars each time you purchased something from their websites or attended their shows. And now you all created monsters. To reverse this damage, all you ever needed to do was boycott the artists that deserve to be fired, and support new artists with a more fulfilling message. The fact that this hasn't happened on its own already is a reflection of where we stand as a society. So the tragedy of Miley Cyrus tells us a lot about ourselves and the environment that we placed her in. Although Miley shouldn't be painted as a victim, she is a big girl and can make her own decisions, but it is we who are to blame for allowing our world to slump so low and not doing anything about it. It's a shame America has tried to be the hero for the whole world but can't ever seem to be a hero to itself. We desperately need to make some changes immediately to the way we nourish our minds with entertainment, as well as the way we nourish our bodies. Let this be a lesson. We are beginning to see how all our choices add up and affect the future. The world we see around us today is a direct result of the choices everyone made yesterday. Never again will we be asleep to this. Soon Anonymous will be taking out all the trash celebrities and replacing them with artists who have real values. After this, kids will be singing to more positive lyrics and dancing for fun, like it was intended to be, instead of growing up too fast. These things surrounding them as they grow up will promote them to think more creatively, and encourage genius ideas to emerge, instead of thinking at the level of a horny chimpanzee. Our goal is simply to turn our kids into freedom fighters and philosophers, and they will naturally choose the right type of music they want to hear on their own, simply because anything less will be degrading and boring to them. It is a positive shift that I see no reason why anyone would argue against it, except the corrupted. So in closing, when people ask us why we make these videos, why we attack misbehaving celebrities, why we hack terrorist websites, expose lying politicians, police brutality, cult leaders, and pedophiles? We do it all for our children, so that they can still have a world to experience the beauty of life. And nothing can ever be more important than this.
Comes a time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying.
Oh, when it's time to lend a hand to life,
the greatest gift of all.
We can't go on pretending day by day
that someone somehow will soon make a change.
We are all a part of God's great big family, and it's true, you know, love is all we need.
We are the world, we are the children, we are.
Choice we're making, we're saving our own lives. It's truly a better day, just you and me.
Well, send them your heart,
oh,
so they know that someone cares,
so their cries for help will not be in vain.
We can't let them suffer. No, we cannot turn away.
Right now, they need a helping hand.
No, someone lie. We are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start giving.
Just believe, there's no way we can fall.
Well, and I'll see you lies. Oh, that change can only come when we stand together as one.
We are the world,
we are the world,
we are the children,
we are.
Make a better day, just you and me.
We are the world.
We are.
they should have gave this part to Beyoncé.